Swan Lake themed class, and we are going to adapt a real repertoire dance and use some of the steps that we normally do in the syllabi, in your syllabi, to create a dance that resembles something that they do on stage in Swan Lake. So I hope you're excited. I've also worked out a bar. Like I said, we'll be using some of the steps that you know, but just in a different way. So you're still practicing the right steps, we're just practicing them on different music. And all the music that we'll be using today will be the Swan Lake music. So I hope you're as excited as I am. I want you to imagine that you have a beautiful white tutu on, that you have a beautiful Swan Lake headpiece. We'll also be sending you a video tutorial of how you can make your own Swan Lake headpiece. And then we're looking forward to seeing some videos of you doing the actual Swan Lake adapted dance that we'll be learning at the end of this class. So let's start with our pliés. So for pliés, again, grab a chair, make sure you are dressed for class. It just helps with your discipline. It helps us stand up tall. And let's quickly go through that. So make sure you zip up your tummies. Your neck is nice and open, your little toes are on the floor, and it's as if you have your beautiful ballet stockings on that pull our knees straight. Our tummies are zipped up, back zipped down, like the tutu. The tutu is completely straight, so it's not bending forward or leaning backwards. It's just straight, parallel to the floor, and you have beautiful earrings and a crown on your head, so a long neck, and I want to see a beautiful ballet face as well. And for the plié exercise, we're going to put our feet in a fifth position. So a beautiful crossed fifth position with our little toes on the floor. And when the music starts, we'll put our hand on the bar and we point to second to go. Demi and stretch, rise and lower. Demi and stretch, point, close in first. And I want you to make sure you use the floor, all the parts of the bones of your foot on the floor. To go again, and demi, little toes on the floor. Remember, it should be feeling like I'm pushing my knees behind my shoulders. And stretch, rise, and lower. We go demi, keep the heels into the floor. Stretch, point closing, fifth. Again, demi, and stretch. Head erect, five, and six, and down, and up. Really push the floor away, get this heel forward, close at the back, and demi, and stretch, rise, and lower, demi, and stretch to go, point, closing first. Now, if you are grade 2, or about 8 years old, you might not know this step, but we're just going to do a demi plié, and then go a little bit further and allow our heels to lift up, to do a grand plié, get our heels down on the floor very quickly, and come up. And remember, in a grand plié, we don't want to sit there. So we don't want to go to where it's comfortable. You just go to where you almost can't hold it anymore. You put your heels down and you come up. And we point to second to do the same thing. But now our heels are not allowed to lift off the floor. So you go as far as you can and keep the heels into the floor. Push the knees back and up, point, close in fifth position. We prepare the arm. And we do a nice forward bend as if we are a prima ballerina. And now our tutu should be flat up facing the roof. And we come up. And I want you to rise, find your balance, zip up your tummy. And if you can, leave the bar and just try to stay there. Hold 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift through the fingers. And when we come down, we squeeze as if there's jelly. And we hold it there. Let's quickly try that with some music. Ready? Act. Hand on the bar. Wait 2 seconds. We do demi. Demi. Rise. Lower. Demi. For this one, we'll start in fifth position again, as this is what we normally do in class. And we are going to put our hand on the bar, and this one is just going to stay in fifth on bar. And we do tendu front. Now remember, if you flex your foot, your toes still want to look to that side wall. So I want you to make sure that that heel is still in the same angle as it was when it was here. So we go push the heel forward and close to the side, close behind, to the back and in, and ding me and stretch, and back and close to the side, keep the heel to the front and close to the front and in, and a soft demi-plie where we incline our head. Then we do dégagés, but first we're going to do piqué. So we go and a touch, and a two, and three, and a four, and a close, and open, close, and open, touch, and a two, and three, and a four, and close, plié, push, close behind to go again. Back, tendu, in, and side, and in, and front, and in, and a demi-plié. Again, front, and in, and side, and in, and back, and in, and demi-plié, and touch, and two, and three, and four, and close in first, dégagé, close, and out, and a one, and two, and three, and four, and close, plié, and push, point, closing, fifth position. Let's try that with music. I hope you're standing ready. Ready, act. We begin the vent. The vent. Second. Derrière. And a demi-plié. Again. And back. And side. And front. Demi-plié. Let's start with piqués. One, two. Thank you. the idea is that either you do this class tomorrow and you do everything on the other side, so you can move your bar to the other side, you can face me and you can follow along using your other leg, your left leg, or you can stop the video, quickly rewind, turn around and do it on the other side today. Okay, it's up to you. You can do the class as many times as you like. Just remember to do both sides. Moving on to a rond de jambe exercise. We'll start in fifth again. Remember, rond de jambe is all about the legs working together. So even though this leg is moving, the leg that you are standing on is the one that's stabilizing you. So I want you to make sure that first of all, the leg that you're standing on, the toes are facing sideways, okay? So that it's not turning in as we go. And while it's facing sideways, we try to keep that little toe on the floor. And if you do it right, you should feel a burn at the back of your bum here. Then you know that you're using your turnout muscles and you are not just squeezing your foot into a position, okay? Or forcing your foot into a position. So when the music starts, we are just going to go prepare and to second. And the. Now, when the music starts, I want you just to prepare and open your arms. Then we go front and side and back to first. And when you go through first, your toes need to still face, be in a proper turned out first position. So they need to face the sides of the room, okay? And then we go again, front. Remember, if you flex that foot, it should look the same as the leg that you're standing on. So it's not turned in. It's facing the side. When I go to the side, it's still facing, it's still the same, okay? And when I go to the back, it should still look the same. So it's not turned in. In fact, it's turned out even more so that heel is facing the floor. Okay, so for the exercise, we go front and side. Keep the heel forward to the back and zip it up. And the front and side and back and a close. Now we're going to go plie, front and side, keep this knee facing this chair, and back and close. To go, bring my arms down, let's keep this hand on the bar, and forward and open to start again. And back and side, and it should feel like this leg is moving because I'm turning it out so much, that's why I move it. Three. And four, and a back, and side, zip it up, three, and a four, plie, back, and a side. Keep the little toe on the floor, so don't let this ankle roll, keep this knee up, front, and close. We bring the arms down, prepare, a big preparation as if we're saying thank you, and we come down. Let's quickly try that with the music, ready? Ready, and fifth position, prepare, and we go front, side, back, try not to stop, front, side, back, close, plie, front, keep your head the same height, we bring the arm down, forward, up, start again to the back, little toe leads, bring the heel, and grow. And zip it up as you go along. We go plie, back, side, front, up. We bring the arms down and a big finish. And let's finish the bar with an adage exercise. You can start in fifth position, and when the music starts, we just put our hand on the bar and we take a deep breath. And as you take this breath, I want you to feel like you're growing and everything is pulling up to the roof. So we lift it, little toes into the floor, and we come down. Remember, adage means at ease. So in your face and in your hands, I need to see a softness and a calmness that you might not be feeling, but I want you to take all the tension that you do feel and put it into your core. So your tummy is strong, but everything else has a calmness about it, okay? So we go, and a one, two, and you look over the audience and you see them watching you. Three, and it's like you want to send something out to them. Three, and four, take this knee behind your ear. Five, and to the front. Six, seven. 7 and 8 to go again. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6 to second, 7 and close in to the back to go. 1, 2, take it to the front, keep the hand, 3, 4, 5, 6, turn, 7, 8, so if we take to the bar, and if you want, you can put your leg down, if you've never done this before, if you have, you can keep it up there, then we bend the bottom leg as if we're growing, and point, and zip it up to close, and finish. Okay, so the first time we just unfold to the front, and fold to the side, close at the back, take it back to the knee. Now we go to the front and we touch the side. We keep this foot in a lock. It's almost like I'm putting my foot somewhere. This is a good way to practice. Put it somewhere. And now I go on my toe and I bring my heel. And that is a fuerte. And back. Okay. So the knee, the heel stays to the floor, but my foot stays exactly where it is. So when I'm here, I'm just going to lift and close, point and zip. Let's try that with the music. Ready. You did a great bar. I hope you feel warm and you stretched out a little bit. If you didn't, quickly pause and do that. But this next exercise is going to be an exercise especially for our arms, because in the dance that we'll do, we're only going to keep our arms still because you'll be holding hands with some friends of yours. So I thought it would be a good idea to quickly do some arms that also reflect the swan leg. Okay, so when they do when they want to show that they are swans, most of that comes by the use of the arms. So even though their feet do normal ballet steps, a lot of the portrayal of being a swan is done through the soft arm movements. Okay, so we'll practice a little bit of that while also still practicing your normal border brass. So here, I want you to try, we'll start with the elbow. So it's almost like you turn your arms in, you bend, and then it's like you push through until your fingertips and to your fingertips, to your fingertips. And you'll feel it works here from your neck into your lats and your shoulders. Okay, so with this one, we'll face the corner, any corner, the left hand side in front. For me, this is corner 2. And we are going to go on the introduction, just to breathe and in to go. 1, 2, open 3, 4, turn your palms, and now we are a swan. Remember, the arms are not behind us because we don't want to arch our back. They're still a little bit in front of us. You need to, if you're looking forward, you need to be able to see your hands. To go, breathe, and breathe or fly, and then we turn the palms and we push down, 7, 8. To go to a third border roll, 1 and 2. Open, 3 and 4, turn, 5 and 6, 7, 8, 1 and 2, 3, 4, that with music. When you finish with this exercise, your biceps, your deltoids, your biceps and your triceps at the back should be burning a little bit. Okay, let's try. Twice if you struggle a bit. Remember the coordination of this one. We go down and it's as if we're peeping underneath this arm and then we go balance it out in second and we throw the water out this side. We scoop down to draw some more water down and it goes over to this side again. So we give to these people and it goes over. We pull the water out on this side and we come. Just because we can, in the center, we're going to do a releve exercise. I believe by this stage, you've all done releves, échappé releves, and releves in fifth. Some of you might not have done a releve passé, but it's a good time to learn. Okay, so for this one, I want you to practice keeping your arms in demi-second. A good way to think about it is if you were wearing a tutu, your hands would just be around that tutu. Okay, so we'll go and out. And change feet. So the feet go out at the same time, they come in at the same time. And two, and down, and three, and down, and four, and down. Now I want you to go up, hold, hold, and down. And now we take the front foot, we touch our knee, they're in the little hole that God made for your toe. And to the back, stretch, to go again, and out, change feet, and out, fifth positions, out. Fifth positions, out, fifth positions, and up, and stay, and stay, and down, up, and down, stretch, and finish, proudly. Okay, this one has more the feel of the black swan, so I want you to put a little bit of épaulement, if you've done that before. If not, épaulement is simply smelling the perfume on this side, smelling the perfume on that side, so it's just a feeling. I want you just to put a little bit of attitude in, okay? Seeing that we are all Swan Lake, Swan Laked up. Okay, let's do that with music. Ready? And out, in. Woo! Let's try with music. And out, out, in. Out, out, in. Out, keep the heels forward. Out and in. Up and hold and hold and down. Up to the back. Stretch. Let's try again. And out, out, in. Out, out, in. Out, out, in. Out, out, in. Up and hold and hold and down. Up and stay. Start with our Swan Lake section. You'll see I'm wearing a Swan Lake headpiece or a Swan Lake clip, and it's simply a little clip that I've stuck some beautiful flowers, some beautiful feathers to, and we've put some diamante embellishments on there. I've just used a glue gun stuck the ends together and put a little clip in. But we will also be sending you a tutorial of how to make your own, just for fun. Okay, but let's get to the dance. When I send the class with the YouTube video, there's a link to a real version of the dance that we're going to do now, and you'll see that they have a lot of head movements that they use in the dance. Okay, so their arms are pretty still. They hold hands. They're actually four little swans, and they hold hands with each other, and they keep holding hands until the very end, until they leave hands when we do the jeté section, and they kneel. That's how they finish. So the whole dance is done holding hands with our friends. Okay, but for this class, we will be practicing by ourselves and practicing to hold our arms in demi-second. And remember, I've made it a little bit, I've adapted it to use the moves that you know, so that we just resemble what they do there. Okay, but what I want to challenge you with is I want you to go watch that video and try and see all the head movements that you can find. So remember, we have head erect, head inclined, head raised, head lowered, and head turned. But then sometimes you can use a combination. So I can go, I turn my head and I incline it a little. Then I'm looking down. Or I incline it and I look up. So then it's turned and it's inclined. So I want you just to go watch that video. Look at all the head movements. There's head turned, head inclined, head raised. And I want you to see where you can find them. Okay, but for today, so our version is going to work like this. So you'll start with your left foot in front. And on the introduction, we'll take our arms out and we do a little jeté. Okay, so remember, jeté goes brush and jump. Okay, and then we're going to go coupé. So this foot stays where it is, but I change my feet. So I go to the back foot and I lift the front foot and change three. So we do three of them, and then I want you to jump onto this foot and straighten the back leg. Okay. So one and two and three and four to go. One and two and three and four. Now grade threes, you will know this one. Grade twos, you will also get there. So we go behind, side, front, changement to go with the left foot, jeté. To go again, and back foot, front foot, back foot, straight to go. Behind, side, front, change my foot, jeté. Every time I do the jeté, I use my back foot. Okay, let's just recap that once more. One, and two, and three, jeté. To the back, to the front, to the back, jump out. Behind, side, front, change my feet, left foot. To go again, back and front, and back and front, up, back, jump, out, behind, side, front. So from here, I go straight, straight down, change my feet, brush, jump. Okay, that last one, we're just going to go behind, side, front, change my feet, straighten my legs. Okay, let's just do that little section. Move that away on the music. Let's try it on the music. Ready? Two, three, one, two, three, four, five and six, seven and eight. Backwards, front, back and out. Behind, side, front, change and stay. Did you get it right? I'm sure you did. If not, quickly go through it again. Moving on to the second part, so that was part number one. It's the one where we go jeté and we do coupé. One and two and three and out. Behind, side, front, that's a pas de bourrée. Changement, jeté. Okay, the second part goes like this, and we've done it in the relevé exercise. You're gonna go out and in. So remember, we have the left foot in front, behind, side, front, change my feet. To go. Out and right and out and left, out and right and out and left, up, hold and hold and down. Now I want you to set your head the opposite way to the leg that you're lifting. Up, close that section on the music, but from the beginning. Ready? 2, 3, and back, front, back, and out, behind, side, front, change, left foot, and back, front, back, and out, behind, side, front, change, step, and out, 2, 3, 4, up, and up, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, up, and to the back, good. So part one started with the jeta and we did the coupes. Part two is the échappé relevés with the relevé passé, okay? Now we've finished with our left foot, we're going to cheat it a bit. You're going to take your back foot out, okay? And this next section is the posé coupé section. So we go up, up, down, and two, and down. So it goes up, and push that foot forward. Woo! I pushed my shoe off. So from here, I'm going to go up to the roof, and then stay there as if I'm coming down to sit. And up to the roof, kick this foot forward. So right foot stays in front, left foot stays the foot that I stand on. And number three, and down. Close, change my feet, and up, up, down, and up, up, down, and up, up, down, and close, and change. Okay, let's try all of that on the music up until there. We are almost done there. We have done 3 out of 4 parts. J'étais, 1, 2, 3. Behind, side, front, change my feet, j'étais, to the back, to the front, to the back, jump out, behind, side, front, change my feet, and stay, out, 2, 3, 4, up and hold and hold, up and hold and hold, again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and up and hold and hold. Up and hold and hold. Up, up, down. Up, up, down. Up, up, down. Change. Left foot. And up, up, down. Up, up, down. Up, up, down. And change. Yes. So we're coming to the last part in the real version. You'll see they're basically doing a lot of what we are doing, but it's just much, much faster. So if you've practiced this a whole lot of times and you can do it easily with your eyes closed, then you can do it fast. Try it fast on the music, okay? Moving on to part four, you'll see you have your right foot in front now, and we are just going to go, we did up, up, down, close, changement, okay? So there with the close, we just do 2 changements so that we can do padishas. And I want you to take your hands into the padisha position, or you can keep them up, but try to put them in the padisha position. We'll do 3 padishas. And a 1, and a 2, and a 3, change my legs. And a 1, and a 2, and a 3, and change. Now you know this, it's not hard for you. Now we do jetai. And j'étais hop, my arms are in demi-second again. J'étais hop, step and hop and point. To go again, j'étais hop. So from here, I've just jumped on this foot. J'étais hop, rush. J'étais hop, step and hop, point. And kneel. And that is the whole dance. This is where we finish. You're welcome to finish here too if you want to. Okay, so this last section, we did pose, coupe, close, change, change, parisha, and a 2, and a 3, and change, parisha, and a 2, and a 3, and change, j'étais hop, step and hop and touch, j'étais, step and hop and touch, and kneel. Let's try that on. on the music. If you need some water, you can quickly get some. Are you ready to do your first adapted repertoire piece? Let's go. Ready? Jeta. Back and front. Back and out. Behind, side, front. Change, left foot. And back and front. Back and out. Behind, side, front. Change, stay there. Out and two, three, four. Up and hold and hold. Up and hold and hold. Remember to breathe. Out. Two, three, four. Up and hold and hold. Up and hold and hold. And up, up, down. This is the time to rest. Last one. Close. Change. Up. Change, change, body shot. Two, three, change mark. Body shot. Two, three, change mark. Jete hop, jete hop, step and hop and touch. Jete hop, te hop, step and hop. And stand up and finish. And I want you to give yourself a big round of applause. Because right now, you danced as long as dancers in a professional company would dance this dance. And as you are feeling now, your heart is probably beating and you are short of breath. That is exactly what they feel like after they've done this dance. And then they go back into the quarter ballet and they dance for about 2 hours more. Okay, so there's a big lot of stamina that goes with it. And we can really respect what they do, but you can also feel very proud of what you've done just now. Just like them, after they finished, they do a reverence, or they do a curtsy, and the curtain goes up, and people clap. So after you've done this, for everyone in your home, I hope you've performed it, you have a little show. Once you've practiced it a little bit and you've made your headdress, then have a performance, and then afterwards remember to do your reverence, which is the French word or the other word for curtsy. Okay, we're going to do a combination of what you would normally do. So we would go, and a one, step two, hands on your two, two, three, four, and I want you to go down, five, you pick up your flowers and you give it away, and you step close to go again, one, and step two, very proud of yourself, and we say a humble thank you, three, to all the musicians who played the music, and we bend down and we give them our flowers and we step forward. I want you to finish in fifth position. And after we've done that with music, we'll take some time to just quickly thank our bodies, thank ourselves for what we've done now, every muscle, and we'll thank God for giving us this instrument and for the fact that it's healthy and that we can do what we do. Okay, so let's quickly do that with music. Ready? First position, and we go one, two, three, four. Pick up your flowers and give them away. And step one and two, three and four, five and six. And step forward, close in the fifth position. Just quickly feel your breath. Feel your heart beating. Hopefully there's some sweat at the back of your back or at your back, lower back. Just take a moment and thank this body. Give it a hug. Every muscle. Every muscle. Mind. Your mind worked hard now to take in all the music, to learn all the new steps. I want you to feel proud. And we just want to thank, we thank God for our instrument, for all these muscles, and for the way we can develop them. Thank you for giving us this health. Help us use it as a gift to bless other people with. Thank you so much for spending this time with me. I hope you had as much fun as I had. Next time, hopefully, we can do something in a beautiful tutu. But go make your headdress, have lots of fun, and remember to send me your feedback on the head movements in that variation that you watched, as well as a video of you doing this beautiful choreography. Have a great day. Bye-bye.